So tonight I ask you to close your eyes and visualize being alone. Maybe you are out at sea, waiting to be rescued. Maybe you are lost in a desert, looking for something to drink. Or maybe you are just sitting in your house, looking at the four walls and wondering, will this ever get easier? The night before Jesus died, he too felt the same way. He didn't want to go on. He asked his Father, God, to help him. He asked his closest friends to stay awake with him, and they fell asleep when he needed them most. He knew he was soon to be captured and likely tortured, and he begged his Heavenly Father to let his cup pass him by. The suffering Jesus went through was intense. So now unite yourself with Jesus. Tell him about your loneliness and listen to him while he explains his. Tell him how you feel and then let him take you on a journey to the kingdom where Jesus now resides. Continue to close your eyes and look out at the beauty of heaven. All you can see is beauty and a scene of serenity. Then you notice way off in the distance a scene that you've seen many times before. You see Mary and Joseph kneeling by a crib. All you can see is the light rising from between them. You keep looking, and then almost if by magic, you now start to see others who are also kneeling around Mary and Joseph. They are all so still, so quiet. They seem so quiet and content. Then, as you focus more on those around Jesus, the faces of those kneeling become brighter, and you see that those who you are looking at are your deceased loved ones. You desperately want to run to them and give them a big hug. Then you realize they seem so peaceful, so happy. It just doesn't seem like there's any reason to disturb their peace. So you too choose to kneel down and be at peace, knowing that your loved ones are very much calm and peace-filled. You are given that night the confidence that if we continue to live our lives on earth and follow the way of Jesus Christ, that you will join your loved ones someday in the everlasting life of heaven. Jesus then asks you to get up and lead you to another area of heaven. Now in the distance there is no mistaking the vision of the cross, and Jesus is hanging on it. Instead of the peaceful scene you just left, you see nothing but tears and sadness. You now begin to see the faces, and just like before, you begin to recognize the people. Here, you see some of those people who have hurt you. Maybe it's a child of yours who no longer speaks to you, or a spouse from whom you've had to separate. Some parents might have been abusive to you, and you see them. You see others who look to be struggling with sickness and pain. You can't help thinking to yourself how different this place is from before. Instead of kneeling down here in peace, you want to run away as fast as you can. The pain and the hurts are just too much to handle. So you turn to run, and you run right into the arms of Jesus, who wraps his arms around you like a soft fleece blanket. He tells you not to worry because it will be okay. He tells you that the scene was not heaven at all, but rather it was life on earth. He assures you this was never the way God the Father planned it, but unfortunately, this is the way free will may it turn out. We now open our eyes and come back to the reality in this world. We have vividly seen the difference between life here and eternity with God. We realize that our loved ones are okay, and that we can wait to rejoin them in the eternity. We realize whatever is making us grieve today will not last forever. We come back to this world with a deeper understanding of the eternal life to come, and recognizing our role in helping the sick and the grieving. We see that through our baptisms we have been called to help the financially poor, as well as the spiritually poor, in helping them to get a better understanding of the beauty of heaven. We come back to this world with a true understanding of the meaning of the birth of Christ, God's only Son. God's Word, made flesh, came into this world to bring us peace, this world and in the world to come, a peace that no human being can ever provide. So, my friends, tonight as we move toward the light of Christmas, we are reminded that we are never alone. Will we feel alone? Of course. Will we continue to hurt, feel horrible pain over the death of our loved ones? Yes, we will. Will we feel the pain of separation or of severe illness? Of course. Is it okay to cry a lot, to feel angry at times, even to feel angry at God? Absolutely. After all, Jesus felt that his Father abandoned him on the cross, and if Jesus can feel abandoned, so can we. But please, my family, promise to yourselves and the Lord that after tonight, you will never look at Christmas again the same. For the Creator of the universe, everything that we can see and beyond, chose to become like us, to suffer terribly and die for one simple reason, that our deceased loved ones, and someday ourselves, can spend an eternity with no more suffering, no more tears, in a totally peace-filled existence with God.